The topic is basic electricity. Today we are going to become familiar with circuit experiment board. Also we are going to learn how to construct a complete electrical circuit and describe those electrical circuit with circuit diagrams. Until this time we interested in static charges. Now we are going to examine flowing charges. I mean the current. Current is the rate of flow of electrical charge in a conductor, and the unit is ampere, and this is the short notation. In a simplest electrical circuit, we have a source, a load, and a current path. Current path is a conductor that connects electrical circuit elements. And if the current path is complete like this, it's a closed circuit. And if the path is broken like this, it's an open circuit. And to create open or closed circuits, we use switch device. If I draw like this, it is an open circuit. If I draw like this, it's a closed circuit. Also, we have protective devices. Mostly we are using fuse, can be shown like this or like this. We are using fuses in order to protect the circuit and the person who use circuit from the overcurrent. When overcurrent comes in the fuse blows and cuts the current and protects. And to create flowing charge in our circuits, we need a voltage supply. Voltage, also known as electromotive force or potential difference, and the unit is volt, and this is the short notation. And 1 volt is the amount of potential difference between 2 points to move 1 coulomb of charge by using 1 joule of energy from 1 point to another. And the load can be a resistor or a electrical device or a more complex circuit. And the resistance is the opposition to current. We are using resistance in our circuits to limit or control to current flow. And the unit is ohm. And we are using omega for short notation. And if there is a near zero resistance in our circuit, we call that circuit a short circuit. And there are two main types of resistance. One of them is fixed and the other is variable. And for the fixed one, ohmic values are set by manufacturers, and the ohmic values followed by color codes and calculated by with this formula we can calculate the ohmic values of those fixed resistances. And for the variable resistances, we can adjust their values by manually or automatic adjustment, like rheostats. If you want to connect two or more resistances in series, total value of resistance is equal to sum of all the resistors. And if our connection is parallel like this, the equation for the total resistance is that. If you want to measure the ohmic value of a resistor, you use ohm meter. While using ohm meter, you must disconnect the power source from the circuit in order to not to harm ohm meter like this. And if you want to measure the voltage, you use voltmeter in parallel connection. And if you want to measure the current, you use ammeter in series connection. Now we can move to the experiment.
Hi everyone. Before beginning to our experiment, I will briefly introduce the instruments that we are going to use in this experiment. The equipment consists of experiment board, which is more commonly known as breadboard, connection cables, here, connection cables, a power supply, which can provide up to 5, several resistors with different resistance values, and a multimeter, which with the correct settings can measure the voltage difference. In the first part of this experiment, we will measure the equivalent resistances between different points throughout our circuit, and we will repeat this process for 3 different types of circuits. A circuit of resistors in series, another one in parallels, and a circuit that has combination of both series and parallels. First, we will determine the resistance values of each resistor. I will connect this resistor here. First, we will determine the resistance values of each resistor. As you can see, this one has 100 ohm resistance. This one is 330 ohm. And the last one is 560. Now for the first circuit, we arrange our resistors in series and measure the equivalent resistance values. This is our circuit in series. The equivalent resistance for R1 and R2 is 429 ohm. The equivalent resistance of R2 and R3 is 887 ohm, and the equivalent resistance of whole circuit is R1, R2 and R3 989 ohm. For the second circuit, we arrange our resistors such that they form a parallel circuit, R1, R2 and R3. We make the necessary connections with the cables. This is our circuit in parallel. Now we are going to measure the R12 value. I will briefly unplug these 2 cables. R12 is 79 ohm. Now I will going to measure the R23. And again, I will unplug these 2. R23 is 207 ohm. And R123 is the equivalent resistance of whole circuit. Is 70 ohm. Now for the last circuit, we form a combination of series and parallel circuits. This is R1, which will be in series to R2 and R3. Make the necessary connections. Now we are going to measure R1. R1 is 101 ohm. R23 is 206 ohm. The equivalent resistance of whole circuit R123 is 307 ohm. In the second part of this experiment, we will operate on the same three circuits, but this time we are going to use a power supply to provide a 5 volt voltage difference to our circuits and measure the voltage differences between the same points. Again, we are forming the series circuit, but this time we are providing a 5 volt voltage differences to our series circuit. The voltage differences across the first resistor, V1, is 0.51 volt. The V2 is 1.66 volt. The V3 is 2.84 volt. V12 is 2.17 volt. V23 4.5 volt, and V123 is 5.02. For the second part, we are going to form the parallel circuit. We have formed the parallel circuit. Now we are going to measure the voltage differences. The V1 is 4.74 volt, V2 is 4.78, V3 4.78 volt. V12 4.80 volt, V23 4.84 volt, V123 is 4.84. Now for the last part, we are going to form a combination circuit. We have formed the combination circuit. The V1 is 1.64 volt, V23 is 3.36 volt, V123 is 5 volt as expected. Now for the third part of this experiment, again we are going to operate on these three same circuits, but this time we are going to measure the current values. So we have formed the series circuit. In order to measure the I0 value, we are going to make a connection from the negative side of this power supply to ammeter, and from the ammeter we are going to make a connection to resistors. The value of I0 is 5 milliampere. I1 is 5.01 milliampere. The I2 is 5 milliampere. And the I3 is 5 milliampere. We have formed the parallel circuit. This current here is I0, which is coming from the power supply to the circuit. This current here, which is going from the circuit to power supply, is I4. The current going through this resistor is R1, this one is R2 and R3. Now we are going to measure I0. I0 is 69. Tamam. The current going through the first resistor is I1 is 47.5 milliampere. I2 is 15 milliampere. And the I3 is 8.7 milliampere.